Ucypher, India's first multi-gaming, multi-platform esports championship. 6 teams of 14 players each compete across 4 games. Counter-Strike Global Offensive, Dota 2, Tekken 7, and Real Cricket 17. Each team faces the other team twice in the league stage. And 3 points each are awarded to the winning team of Tekken 7 and Real Cricket 17 in each match. 5 points each are awarded to the winning teams of Dota 2 and CSGO games in a match. The top 4 teams in the league stage move to the knockout rounds. Ucypher, 6 teams, 84 cyber athletes, and a grand prize pool of 51 lakh rupees.
Day 13, and I'm sitting with the guys who are sitting comfy with 39 points, guys. That's a comfortable spot on the leaderboard. Acrid?
Yes, very comfortable, but we are aiming for 1.
First spot, you mean?
Yes.
Which means today is going to be a wipeout.
Yes.
All 16 points are yours.
Definitely.
I am loving this spirit. I heard about both of you, Skadoosh and Sneeze, having been rivals before this.
Yes, we were. We don't like each other, that everyone knows here. But it's just that we are matured enough to eat up our egos for all these guys who've been cheering us, who've been supporting us, and we love each other a lot, so it's fine.
So you're basically playing together for the greater good. Skadoosh, is that right?
What he said is correct. The second part of that is, it's in the spirit of the game.
Hmm.
When we are here as gamers, gaming comes first.
Very well said, man. Get ready for battle.
Yes, let's go!
Yakshas!
Let's go!
Yakshas!
Let's go!
Yakshas! Let's go, Sherdils!
Captain Cool and his squad, Sherdils. Aaj ka game bahut interesting hone wala hai because aaj hum kuch epic matchups dekhenge. Sabse pehla hoga Hans aur Jaunty Tank ka. Excited ho?
Haan, abhi tak bahut zyada excitement thi, lekin jab se pata chala hai ki tum Varun matlab hum log ki side hai, tab se bahut tension ho rahi hai. Aur dekho iska dil dekho bhai dhak 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 dhak. Matlab kya ho gaya hai?
Aapke last game mein aapka losing record toota.
Haan.
When you made Falcon the in game leader.
Haan.
Falcon, welcome back to the team. आपने अपना जो presence है वो दिखाया. And you got Sherdils to the victory. आज आप वही चीज करने वाले हो या फिर something new, something innovative?
आज मैं बस इतना ही करूँगा कि जैसा हम continue करते आए वैसे ही करें और सब players अपना part करें और freely करें और मैं उनका जितना भी talent है वो निकालने की कोशिश करूँगा और साथ में उनके साथ उनका साथ देके उनके साथ खेलूँ और कुछ नहीं.
Welcome to Match Day 13. We have an exciting matchup today between the Sherdils and the Yakshas.
Quick look at the leaderboard. Marksmen have gone way in the lead with 47 points.
Right.
But Yakshas are right on the trail with 39 points. And Sherdils are not far behind by 35 points out.
Exactly, Amar. But the match that I'm waiting for today is between Jaunty Tank and Hans. Both the players are so dominant so far in this competition. No one seems to know how to beat them. I guess we'll find out who can finally lose and the other guy get the first blood. And then we have the CSGO competition where both our ex-teammates, Impale versus Ritesh, Ritz. Both are going against each other, both very experienced players.
Yes. And then moving on to Dota 2, yeah. Yakshas have been having an unsteady game where they've lost the first match, won the first match, lost again, won again.
Right. Acrid needs to step up as the captain today and do what his team requires him to do and get those points for him. So we have a super exciting lineup today.
Let's get into the game.
Today's first game of the day is going to be a true clash of the titans because none of our teams here have ever lost a game of Tekken 7. Have a look at the rules before we go into this bloody battle.
प्लेयर्स अपने कैरेक्टर सिलेक्ट करेंगे हर राउंड में जिसका एचपी खत्म हो जाएगा वो राउंड हार जाएगा हर मैच एक रेस है 3 राउंड्स जीतने की और जो प्लेयर पहले 3 मैचेस जीतेगा वो बनेगा टेकन 7 का विनर लेट द बैटल बिगिन
साइफर का टेकन 7 में सबसे ज्यादा अवेटेड मैच Jaunty Tank versus Hans. Jaunty Tank एक ऐसा प्लेयर है जिसने हर टेकन प्लेयर को शॉक कर दिया कतरीना के साथ.
That sounds scary.
Are you scared? या फिर ये सकाज़म है?
वो तो गेम के बाद पता चलेगा ना. वो ऑप्शन प्लीज मेरे पे रखो.
आज आप कौन सा फाइटर लेने वाले हो?
आज मैं जैक सेवन लेने वाला.
आपका रिकॉर्ड है फेंग, किंग, जैक सेवन और कोई नया कैरेक्टर नहीं लिया ना अभी तक?
वो अगले गेम में.
अगले गेम
एक रेडी है.
थोड़ा इस गेम में थोड़ा एक्सपीरियंस के साथ थोड़ा सा.
हाँ नहीं, जैक इसलिए ले रहा हूँ क्योंकि हाई डैमेजिंग मूव है, राउंड जल्दी खत्म होंगे.
This is the opening of your day, and as usual, we're beginning with Jaunty Tank. And you've only been playing with Katarina.
Yeah.
So is Katarina gonna give this guy a fight or what?
Yeah, obviously, I'm looking forward for this game as I go 1 pound at a time. Mm-hmm. So it doesn't matter who am I playing.
Yakshas, how are we feeling, man? Acrid?
Amazing. Buzzing. And always. Yes, Jaunty always delivers, and today also he will deliver. He's 4-0. He's also 4-0, Hans. So आज किसका तो streak खत्म होने वाला है. I'm pretty sure आज Hans का streak खत्म होगा.
Let's go! Let's go! Let's go! Let's go!
Woo! Welcome back to another game of the Ucypher League. Today it's gonna be Sherdils versus the Yakshas. On Yakshas we have Jaunty Tank, and on Sherdils we have Hans. Let's get into the action and the fight begins.
Round one. Fight.
We go with a nice combo at the start and a jawbreaker to Jack 7. He's already low on HP, a 40% damage already taken. But that piston gun move and the whip to the ground. Jack 7 going for the blast move, but no, Katrina comes in with a nice combo and the jawbreaker again. He is low on HP and has the rage art right now to use. But that hammer rush knocked Katrina out. So round one taken by the Sherdils.
Fight.
Jack 7 is taking some damage from Katrina, but the blast did work, and now he is gonna go for a combo. A huge damage for Katrina over here, and Katrina with a nice 2 lower hits, and what amazing combos from Jack 7. Katrina just on 10% of HP, just a hit away from knockout, and there it goes. That's a knockout.
Round 3. Fight.
To Jack 7, but even Jack 7 with a nice blast to her, but that was blocked from Katrina, and he is now going low on HP. Well, even a 2-point lead on his side, and he is just rushing this YOLO move from Jack 7, and that hit is gonna be a knockout. And the series has been match number 1 of best of 5, 3-0.
Round 1. Fight.
Match number 2 starts with Jack 7 quite aggressive towards Katrina. And now Katrina with a nice comeback into the game. She is going to give that jawbreaker to Jack 7, but nice blocks from him as well. And that blast is going to give Katrina a lot of damage. She has the rage art to work with right now. And now both of them maintaining that space, respecting each other. And here it goes. The rage art is on Katrina. It does connect. And it can be the end of Jack 7, but no, it's a slight bit of HP still left on Jack 7. He pulls the rage out from him, and it does connect, and Katrina is surely gonna be a knockout.
Great. Round 2. Fight.
Let's jump into the next round. And the start of the round, that piston arm on Jack 7 is gonna give Katrina a huge damage. But now Katrina coming back into the game again with the same combo, that jawbreaker on Jack 7. Jack 7 now just rushing into Katrina there. Look at the damage taken from Katrina. She has the rage art, pulls it on time, and it does connect. Jack 7 taking some huge damage from that rage art. But both of them currently on equal HP. Jack 7 going for the blast, it connects. She is so low on HP, just a hit away. Nice block from her. But Jack 7 reading the game really well and wins it. But this could be the last round of match number 2 if the Sherdils win it. And looks like they are just dominating Katrina in this game. She's already low on 50% of her HP. And now taking some more damage. But again with the same combo on Jack 7. Well, she did manage to get him down on 50% of his HP as well. But look at Jack 7 not showing any mercy on Katrina and going for the knockout. And Sherdils win match number 2, 3-0.
Round 1.
Max number three begins. Jackson, look at him. That's total domination from him. Not giving a single chance to Katrina.
Round two. Fight.
And Jackson again with that twisting arm to the face. It's not looking good for the Yakshas. And now Katrina has the rage art, but it was like close to perfect for Jack 7. But again, Katrina with the same combo, like trying to keep that distance from Jack 7 right now. But it's gonna be a knockout. This could be the last match for the game if the Sherdils win this. And looking at currently the stats, Hans is just humiliating the Yakshas. It's not looking good for them. Both of them just trying to keep that safe distance, but now Jackson again with that twisted arm under the face. Katrina going low on HP, he drags her. This move is insane. He is just putting some pressure on Katrina, and that's a knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, the winners are the Sherdils.
Let's go, Sherdils!
Ucypher mein undefeated in Tekken 7. How does it feel?
It feels great, man.
आज तक जॉन्टी टैंग को किसी ने नहीं हराया है।
नहीं तो हार के ही तो बंदा सीखता है। मतलब मैं भी शुरुआत में बहुत हारता था।
गुरुदेव, गुरुदेव, क्या शिक्षा दी आपने इनको आज? After the first game, Hans remains unbeaten in Ucypher. The scores are Sherdils at 3 and Yakshas at 0. Congratulations, Hans. Congratulations. All the best, Sherdils.
Wow, Mikhail, I didn't predict this happening, man.
You didn't?
3-0 by Hans to Jonty. He won the game swiftly and quite easy and comfortably.
Jonty Tank ne jo start kiya was pretty impressive. Unhone kaafi damage kiya. Hans looked a little worried in the first set. लेकिन उन्होंने काफी जल्दी अपने अपोनेंट का गेम रीड किया कैटरीना का जो मूव कॉम्बिनेशन था स्टार्ट रीडिंग दैट एंड देन यू कुड सी द रिजल्ट्स इन द सेकंड एंड थर्ड सेट काफी आसानी से जीतने लगे उसके बाद
अप नेक्स्ट वी हैव रियल क्रिकेट 17 छह बॉल्स दो गेमर्स बहुत नाइंसाफी है अभी तक यूसाइफर में हायर स्कोर गया है 34 रन क्या आज कोई 36 बना पाएगा वो जानने से पहले लेट्स हैव अ लुक एट द रूल्स
ये एक बैटिंग ओनली मैच है हर प्लेयर एक ओवर फेस करेगा जिसमें उसे मैक्सिमम रन्स बनाने होंगे मैक्सिमम रन्स बनाने वाला प्लेयर मैच जीत जाएगा टाई होने पर दोनों प्लेयर्स एक सुपर ओवर खेलेंगे टू डिसाइड द विनर
इट्स टाइम फॉर द टॉस मेरे पास दोनों कैप्टन्स हैं एक्रिड अगर आप टॉस जीतते हो तो आप क्या चूज करोगे
अगर मैं टॉस जीतता हूं तो मैं सेकंड बैट करूंगा
Ritz. First bat.
First bat. Target set karo or pressure set karo. Good, good move. Okay, kaun call karega?
Oh, main karunga. Heads.
Heads it is.
I will bat first.
Chase, jo chahiye tha aapko. All the best.
Yep,
all the best.
You. Good luck.
Hello and welcome back to Ucypher League. And today it's gonna be the Sherdils versus the Yakshas. On Sherdils we have Anoop and on Yakshas, we have Eyeball. Four. The second ball comes in. And it's an LBW. He is out. The third ball, he misses it. It's a dot ball for the Sherdils. The fourth ball comes in and he misses that as well. Four runs, four balls, a pretty bad score. This is the second last ball of the over and he misses it. Well, this is the last ball and even the captain has lost hope. And he lifts it, it's going for a boundary. Six runs, so finally they get 10 runs in six balls. The Yakshas need 11 runs in six balls to win the game. So now it's Yaksha's turn to bat and even two sixes will work for them. So two balls can end this game. It's the first ball coming in for them and he has whacked it towards the boundary. It's going for a six. More five runs needed to win the game. Second ball coming in, and that was a Yorker, and he has whacked it again towards the boundary. The Yakshas win the game.
Our single player gamers ab aaram kar sakte hain because it's time to move on to the big ones. We're moving into our five pointer games, which means five gamers in each team and a substitute player to fill in whenever necessary. I'm talking about CS:GO.
Is game mein do teams hoti hain, ek terrorist team aur dusri counter terrorist team. Ye ek team based game hai jo 5 versus 5 ke format mein khela jayega. प्लेयर्स कौन सा मैप खेलेंगे ये एक बैनिंग प्रोसेस से तय होगा। शुरुआत में दोनों टीम्स को $800 की गेम करेंसी मिलती है। The aim of the terrorist team is to plant the bomb and secure it or kill all the counter terrorists. The aim of the counter terrorist team is to either defuse the bomb or kill all the terrorists. इस मैच में 30 राउंड्स होंगे एंड द फर्स्ट टीम टू विन 16 राउंड्स इज द गेम विनर। इन द केस ऑफ अ टाई द रिजल्ट विल बी डिसाइडेड विद अ रेस टू 4 विन्स।
स्ट्रेटजी इज एक्सट्रीमली इंपॉर्टेंट इन CS:GO, सो इंपॉर्टेंट दैट इवन कैजुअल गेमर्स समटाइम्स यूज CS:GO एज अ टीम बिल्डिंग एक्सरसाइज फॉर देयर कोवर्कर्स एंड देयर कॉलीग्स। तो देखते हैं स्ट्रेटजी रूम्स में क्या चल रहा है।
व्हिच आर द मैप्स यू गोना प्ले टुडे?
I feel Cobble and Train would be like comfortable.
Baba, 99% Mirage aur Train mein se hi aayega pick.
Cunning setup khelte hain. Ek Kerrigan khelega, ek Cold khelega, ek Ally khelega. Hum log advantage mein hi rahenge kyunki wo log khali aggressive khelenge.
Skadoosh aur basically Achu ko gamble karna acha lagta hai to Train zyada prefer karenge.
Wo log ne agar Ally target karna chalu kar diya na apne apna upper hai agar usko fall back karna hai. Wo tere ko bacha nahi sakta. Wo time pe khali mere ko bata de main Cold pe hu to main us hisab se side train defensive khelu. Tu Kerrigan rahega to main bhi aggressive aunga.
सामने वाले भद्दे प्लेयर्स है एकदम, उनसे हारना नहीं है।
ठीक है,
जीतने के बाद उनके सामने जाके चिल्लाना है उनको।
लेट्स गो आउट देयर विन दिस वन एज वेल एंड शो देम अंडरडॉग्स बोला ना दिखाते वो लोग को अंडरडॉग्स कौन है टूर्नामेंट।
चलो
लेट्स गो
चलो
I have with me two very important team members of their respective CS:GO teams. Yaksha se Impale and Ritz, of course, the captain of Team Sherdils himself. Guys, I know that you have played together before.
Yes.
Kab tha wo aur kitne pehle?
I think it was 2006 to 2010.
Wow, that's 4 years.
Yeah, and we dominated a lot.
Yeah?
Yeah.
The whole country.
The whole country.
Really?
Yeah. In fact, even the Pakistan came to India. We defeated them.
What?
Yes.
You guys are completing each other's sentences.
He's a brother to me and I was pretty young when we started playing together. So they used to pamper me.
Oh.
So I love the guy, I respect the guy. So he's safe and I don't want to say anything about the rest.
So Achu has a soft spot for you. But do you have a soft spot for him?
In game, yeah, I do. But I only hate one player, Skadoosh, in their team.
So I've heard.
That's
and why is that? Oh yeah, you also hate. Why? Why? Oh my God, there's some mutiny happening here. Why do you hate Skadoosh?
Because he's not a professional player. Bug, 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 bug. All nonsense, rubbish thing. Instead of playing, he just like keeps on yelling.
And that doesn't go down well with Captain Cool, of course. He's all about the game. This is getting feisty, guys. CS:GO is about to begin. All the best.
Thank you so much.
All the best.
Thank you.
This is the map, Vito, and now let's see what are they gonna choose. It's gonna be Train! Ladies and gentlemen, now it's time for some Counter-Strike action between the Yakshas and the Sherdils. It's gonna be the knife round, as you know, and the winner gets to choose the side. And also, it's the favorite map of the Sherdils, as the last one they won against the Acrid. And the knife fight begins. Falcon getting the first frag on Mantri. Recall Master getting free kill. Falcon with the second frag on Skadoosh. And Buster just on Rage Mode. 3 instant kills. Sherdils win the knife round and choose to play STs.
Surprise to my surprise, personally, they picked Terrorist, which is one of my strategies for this particular tournament, where I want to apply pressure on the enemy or enemy ke upar terrorist side se attack kar karke unko pierce karna.
most of the teams choose to play as CTs first, but Sherdils choose to play as Ts. So they would have some different kind of strategy for this map. Yakshas pushing towards the alley side and Falcon waiting towards the P entrance for the inner side. He spots Mantri that was pushing from alley. He shuts him down and Starboy over here gets an instant trade on Falcon. And the C4 is getting planted towards the inner side. Ritz pushing towards the city mid and he finds one. He shuts down one. It's going to be Recall Master to go down. Starboy pushing from behind. He's struggling with his bullet, but Freaky is going to shut him down. So Sherdils take the first round. Freaky holding towards mid, finds Mantri, and that's a single tap. Mantri goes down. Now Freaky going for the second frag towards the CT mid. It's going to be Recall Master going low on HP. A nice damage to him, but Skadoosh with a nice backup over there. He shuts down Freaky. Impale holding towards the inner side. He finds Buster. He shuts him down. Buster has gone down, and Ritz coming in with this nice frag on Impale. Going for the second frag as well. Recall Master goes down, and now it's all on the captain of the Sherdils.
C4 था मेरे पास और सब लोग one by one मेरे crosshair में आते रहे और सारे सब अच्छे lucky shots मैंने मारे.
And the last guy is gonna be Starboy. So quad kill coming in for the captain of the Sherdils. A nice 3-round lead on the Sherdils. And now Ritz is gonna throw the smoke towards the mid train to block off the vision of the sniper, but Recall Master deciding to take a different angle and that pays off. Slots go down. Freaky pushing towards mid. He spots one guy towards the electric box. He shuts him down as well. So Freaky making it a 4v4 situation now. Skadoosh finds Freaky over here towards mid. And Mantri getting one frag, but Ritz with an instant trade. That's how you make a trade frag. Ritz falling back towards the T mid and Impale waiting towards the small ladders. So now Impale moves out. He finds one guy. It's going to be Buster, but Ritz kills Impale. A nice trade frag here as well. Well, Recoil Master shutting down Ritz and defusing the bomb. So now the scoreline stands 5-3. Falcon holding towards mid, waiting for someone to push, and a well-calculated decision. Starboy has gone down.
हमने strategy ये बनाई थी कि हम एक wall बना दे smokes की, जिससे उन लोग हमें attack ना कर पाए, और attack करे भी तो blindly fire करे, उन्हें पता नहीं है हम कहाँ पे.
Skadoosh holding on the side train, firing through the smoke wall, but couldn't find anyone this time, and now he is gonna fire again. Well, he finds Falcon, unfortunate for him, but now Buster on the side train. He is gonna find one frag on Recoil Master. Recoil Master going down over here and Freaky getting one frag on Mantri and second frag on Skadoosh. Two instant kills for him. Impale is the last guy left, a 1-on-4 situation for him. He is now saving his weapon. This is gonna be the last round of the first half. 9-5 the current scoreline, and let's see who's gonna win. Buster getting one frag, that was Impale who was pushing through the smoke, and Freaky towards the outer bomb site. He finds one more frag. It's gonna be Mantri, he's gonna go down. Ritz again with a team kill on his player. It's gonna be Buster going down again, and now Recall Master getting two instant kills for his team. Falcon managing to find Recall Master into the corners, and it's gonna be a one-on-one situation. Falcon versus Skadoosh. Who's gonna win this one? Falcon jumps, and Skadoosh with a nice headshot wins the last round of the first half. So 9-6 the current scoreline.
Interesting first half. The Sherdils won the important knife round, chose the unfavored terrorist side, and are 9-6 up.
The map that has been selected is train, and Sherdils have started off well in it, but Yakshas are not far behind. They were down, final down.
5-0 down.
Yeah, they made a good comeback. And the score's first half is 9-6 right now.
Let's jump back into the second half and see if the Yakshas can make a comeback.
Welcome back to the second half of this game. And now let's see what is going to be the strategy for the Sherdils. Skadoosh smoking off towards the mid. He's pushing with the Molly energy. He spots one guy and finds Ritz, shoots him between the eyes. He gets one frag. Impaled with the second frag on side train. That's going to be Falcon going down, and Freaky with one more frag towards the inner. Skadoosh with a nice backstab coming in from the outer side, but Freaky knows it, so he's gonna shut down Skadoosh. And now towards the inner side, Starboy gets one frag and the second frag as well. Yakshas win this round. Starboy pushing towards outside. He finds Falcon who's burning into the molly and kills him with his SMG. And now Skadoos is gonna find one towards the alley and second frag towards the city mid.
मैंने एक साइट मोल्टो करके एक को बाहर निकाल के मार दिया और तब भी मुझे कॉल आया कि एक सिटी मिड है उसको मैंने मैनेज करके मार दिया.
So Yakshas win the next one as well. Yakshas pushing towards the outside. Molly goes off from the CTs and first frag, second frag as well, and the third one for slots. Triple kill instantly.
Over the time, confidence बढ़ते जा रहा था players का और ये भी था कि वो उनके calling में ऐसा नहीं लग रहा था हमें कि हमें pressure आ रहा है बहुत.
And Ritz ending it off for Skadoos. So now the Sherdils are on match point. They need one round to win this game. Yakshas need to come up with some new strategy because this is going to be the last round for the Sherdils. They are playing aggressive towards the outer side. Impale gets one frag and Buster going for the second one, instantly making it a 4v4 situation. And Impale getting Buster, making it a 4v3 situation. He is now completely blinded with the flashbang. Freaky comes in with nice two easy frags and it's now all on Recoil Master, the lone guy left for the team of Yakshas. Ridge with a nice backstab to Recoil Master. 16-10 the scoreline. Sherdils win it.
Impale ne mujhe aakar kaha ki mujhe target karenge. I'm fine with it. I took matters in my own hand and I had the maximum kills on my team. Unfortunately, we lost.
Wraps up our third game of the day. CSGO was fantastic today, guys. Ritz, this was your game. You guys won and so spectacularly. Like, we saw some players perform today that we hadn't seen before. Anyone in particular that you'd like to mention?
It was Freaky, who came out of nowhere. He was just hitting. He was pretty confident in his skill. And usko kya malum kya ho gaya, but he was on fire.
He was on fire?
Yeah. He completely shocked us, to be honest.
26 kills?
26 kills, yeah.
Acrid, what happened, buddy?
Freaky played really well. Today, I guess, Mantri didn't perform well. But I think it was a great game for us today because lots of learning. And Kapish did a great job today as an IGL because he was 4 to 5 times MVP he was. So, great effort by my team, but it's okay now. It comes through Dota, so it's my game. So, I'm all set for it.
Your boys ready?
Yeah, they were always ready.
Okay, I'm going to let you guys go back to your teams and regroup. Congratulations, that was really fun to watch and all the very best.
Good luck.
Welcome back to Ucypher and Sport, Nice Superstars. Final game of the day. This can turn tables completely. I'm talking about Dota 2.
Dota 2 mein har player apne liye ek hero select karenge. इस गेम में दो टीम्स कम्पीट करेंगी इन अ 5 वर्सेस 5 फॉर्मेट. हर हीरो के पास स्पेशल पावर्स और एबिलिटीज होती हैं. हर टीम का ऑब्जेक्टिव है अपने एंशिएंट्स को डिफेंड करना और अपने ओपोनेंट के सारे टावर्स को डिस्ट्रॉय कर देना. जो टीम पहले एनिमी टीम के डिफेंस को तोड़कर उनके सारे टावर्स डिस्ट्रॉय कर देगी वो टीम जीतेगी.
विद मी आई हैव द कैप्टन ऑफ यक्षास एक्रिड. And Sherdil se have the in-game leader of Dota 2, Mama Sita. ये game आप दोनों के लिए बहुत ज़्यादा important होने वाली है.
आसिफ के against मैं पहले भी खेल चुका हूँ. मुझे पता है आसिफ क्या खेलता है क्या नहीं. तो अभी तो नया पूरा meta change हो चुका है game का. काफी नए updates आए हुए game में. तो it's a 50-50 thing, but I'm pretty confident कि शायद हम लोग ने meta को better read किया होगा उन लोगों से.
He said that you've played with him.
Yeah, I played against him.
And have you won?
I have won some and he has won some, so thoda equal hai.
Who's a better player?
Better player, actually I respect him a lot because he played professionally for 5 to 6 years.
Wow, this is going to be fun. All the very best. Acrid, all the very best, Mama Sita.
Good luck, bro. Good luck.
Both of them sound really confident, but Ucypher mein kuch bhi ho sakta hai. So let's watch Dota 2.
Welcome back to Ucypher. Sherdils will take on the Yakshas today. And I'm CloudX. With me is Vivek. We're watching Punk Acrid dueling it out in a top aggressive lane versus Rival on that Weaver. Punk looping in from the side gets the decay off. Rival's lost a lot of strength, and with that last auto attack, Acrid scores first blood.
Rival, he switched lanes, he's moved bottom, and Kalnayak immediately on top of him, but possibly Kalnayak has stepped too far. Rival is looking to turn this around. He's got the swamp. Kalnayak accepts his fate, looks for the kill, and with the range creeps, he's gonna get it.
They both end up trading one for one now on the top lane, 17 minutes in, 10-7 the score as Disruption gets aggressive. VP taking a bit of a beating here, turns around with a Frostbite. That Mystic Snake jumps to two, comes back. VP looks like he's gonna survive, but the Glimpse is there, pulling him right back into the kinetic field where he's gonna get brought down. Disruption meanwhile standing in the march, taking a hell of a beating here, gets saved by Mamacita. The Sonic Wave just barely missing courtesy the Astral Imprisonment. He blinks out, gets away, and looks like he's gonna survive for now.
VP all by himself in the dire jungle looks to turn Mamacita with the Astral Banks of Time, but Kalnayak is here with the Scream. Sonic Wave on top of the OD. OD dropping low, but nobody falling just yet. Here comes Disruption with the Crush. Rival beating away on Punk. The Static Storm on the floor. They're looking to fight. The Stone Gaze is there as well, but Punk will fall to Mamacita. Well, Acrid doesn't end up getting anyone in exchange here. They're still giving pursuit. Rival just running through the march, moving forward for Appa. He's lost a lot of health. Appa needs to be careful. The laser is going to keep the Visage Familiars at bay, and it seems as if Yakshas might just back out for the time being elsewhere. But Kalnayak, he's gone in. He's got the Linkit Spear. He's fairly healthy. Rival coming in from the back. He's moving on towards VP. He drops the Swarm. TP out from the Tinker. He's going to stay alive. It's a chaotic fight, and at the end of it, no one's fallen just yet. Kalnayak getting glimpsed around. Rival is still here.
What a haphazard fight this has been. Disruption's not done though, just said this is never ending. He's gonna go back and gets the crush, but loses his own life there. Acrid happy to clean that up. Meanwhile, OD comes in, drops the Sanity's Eclipse, doesn't quite get the kill. Acrid gets pulled back by Eclipse. Opa keeping the fight going. Sherdils have managed to turn it around as Khans gets a double. Meanwhile, a crush onto two. Mamacita gets himself up onto a killing spree. It looks like it's going to be another death on the side of the Yakshas. Sherdils moving further and further towards victory.
Acrid, he's just manning up versus Mamacita. Now he's low on mana. He's popped the Storm Gaze. He needs to be careful. Tinkers here in the vicinity, but Rival's got his BKB. He's just going to turn, bring down Appa. And there comes Disruption with the crush, finding the kill on the Kalnayak. Sherdils is chasing for more. They smell blood in the water and they want Acrid, but they aren't going to get it.
Meanwhile, the Hex comes out from the Tinker Weaver, scurrying away like a chicken that he is. Meanwhile, Acrid now farming next to his shrine. Khan's thinking about doing a little bit of damage on the top lane. He's got that Aghanim's upgraded familiars now going to work as well. Khan's pressuring the top lane, but Appa comes in, unveils the sheepstick upon his head. They're doing a fair bit of damage, but Visage just refuses to die. Mamacita, he comes in with the Hex, goes forward with the post up. They've got the Tinker. Can they finish the job? He gets the laser blind and a Hex off. In fact, Tinker's the one that's turning around. Mamacita forced to pop a BKB to get that kill. Now Acrid getting tailed here. Weaver's coming in as well. The Swarm has connected. Mamacita continues to survive. Acrid losing a lot of his mana. They're losing a fair bit of HP as well. The familiar stuns come through to help out. And Rival, he's godlike now and is looking for Punk, who's about to TP out, but Mamacita says no sir, hexes him and finishes the job.
So we're bang in the middle of Dota 2 and we have our experts here to decode this fantastical chaos that's going on.
Right.
Amar, Mikhail, please help me understand what's happening.
So Yakshas has clearly taken lead out here.
Okay.
And especially they're playing a very aggressive game.
Right.
So at the start of the game, usually in Dota, you have different lanes where you kind of split your heroes and
right.
you kind of send them in different lanes and
there
positions.
Are three lanes, right?
Right.
Yes.
Okay.
So there's the top lane, mid lane and the bottom lane.
Uh-huh.
So what Yakshas did is they sent about three heroes in the top lane. And attacked Viva out there from Sherdils, who's played by Rival there. As per Yaksha's draft, they did the right thing. They went aggressive. They had the early attack heroes.
Correct.
So they have stuck to that plan. And now they should make sure that they don't take it into a late game. And if they take it into a late game, I believe Sherdils can capitalize, farm a lot, get the inventory, and then kind of make a comeback.
So all right.
You have to be very careful.
Okay, well, things seem to be turning around for the Sherdils. On that note, we're going to take a short break. On the other side of this break, you will find out what happens at the end of Dota 2. Will it be the Sherdils or the Yakshas?
Phenomenal stuff coming up from Sherdils. They have a huge lead. Rival runs through the march, ends up falling. Opa falls as well. Good work coming up from the Tinker. And Yakshas hold on to the high ground. They're actually getting aggressive. Kalnayak's gone in. He's unloaded the Sonic Wave. Khans needs to be careful. He's being controlled by the Crystal Maiden. Elsewhere, Mamacita manages to find the undying Rival along with Disruption, moving forward, looking for the lane of barracks. Yakshas.
Sherdils really close to claiming a later barracks here, but Yakshas just fighting with everything they've got. Disruption comes in, starts the fight, but did he start preemptively?
Rival chasing Khalnayak here, he's got the Bloodthorn, manages to silence him. The Lincoln Sphere will not keep Khalnayak alive. And with the Swarm, he's eventually going to fall. Disruption comes in, lands the Crush upon Acrid. Acrid being controlled, lets the Stone Gaze off, and that's going to be enough for Sherdils to back away.
Clean escape by the looks of it, but Disruption, he's feeling a little naughty here. He wants to go back in, goes in with the Crush. He's managed to control the Medusa on one side, while Rival is actually going for the measly little Crystal Maiden. Doesn't quite get that kill. They're gonna have to make a run for it here, because Appa came back in as well.
Top lane, Khans, he needs to be careful. Appa's there with the Sheepstick. Acrid just finding a way, this time Storm on the floor, controlling Tinker for the time being. Disabling his Blink, but Acrid with that Scar, he's just pounding away, gets the kill on Opa. But the Tinker, he might not be so lucky. Mamacita's here with the BKB, gets the kill, instant buyback coming up from Appa. Well, Rival with the time lapse is trying to deal with this Medusa, but Acrid is too much. He's bought down Mamacita, taken away his streak. And with Appa coming in, this could be a dieback on the Tinker. Rival's giving chase to Soul Rip. Keeps him alive, and Acrid with the damage keeps things alive, just brings down the Weaver.
Acrid is just a one-man army at this point, walking up the slope. The Disruptor drops down the Static Storm there. He gets the silence off, but what are they really going to do to Acrid? He's just standing there, right-clicking anyone that dares to come in his face. At this point, he might as well just leave his hands off of the keyboard and get off, because there's nothing they can do to stop him. He's gone for the Ancient. Sherdils, they hurry back into their fountain like sheep. Acrid is just going for the win. 59 minutes in, the score completely deceptive about the outcome of this game, but Sherdils, one last stand, they'll come into the Hex Punk, refuses to die before the OD goes down. It's a dieback. He can't come back for this fight. Acrid is just breaking buildings while the rest of Yakshas are hurting the heroes away. This looks like the end of the game. Yakshas will take the victory.
This game of Dota felt like a movie. Actually, this day felt like a movie. Kabhi is taraf, kabhi us taraf, kabhi aap jeet rahe ho, kabhi ye jeet rahe. And you guys lost the Dota game. The scores for today are Sherdils at 8 and Yakshas also at 8. I have a question. Yakshas, aapka MVP kaun tha? This movie ke hero. Right now, you are tied with your best friend's team, Venom's team, at the top of the table. How does it feel?
It feels great. Number one, हमेशा अच्छा ही लगता है. But देखते हैं अभी just अभी just चालू है ना और पांच game बाकी है league के तो आ जाएंगे number one पे.
Nice. So congratulations, captain. Congratulations. You guys played really well.
See you again.
That's the spirit.
And off the win versus the Akramaks in their last leg, they came up against a pretty good side in the Yakshas and. It was a tough battle. In the end, I think it was justified when we saw an 8-all draw because I think it was so hard to pick a winner. You won Tekken, lost the cricket, won CS, lost Dota. Mixed feelings?
Yeah, a lot.
Yeah, I think...
mean, I'm pretty much happy that we won CS, but I was expecting a Dota win, but okay, we lost Dota, chalega.
Yeah, again, but the big plus for you is to start the leg always seems to be Hans, right?
Hans is
it
like
gives you that little wind. Yeah.
It's a fixed deposit, like I said. I'm keep on saying, yeah, our fixed deposit here is the opening batsman. Theek hai.
Yeah.
But a cricket, again, no, like pretty sad for us. He's like keep on losing. He's on the losing streak now. Yeah. I think we just have to motivate him. Okay, you can do it, you can do it. You just practice a lot. Yeah. You can do it, just trust yourself.
Yeah, so your opening batsman, yeah. Hans, is doing the job. The one down batsman is a little bit of an improvement. Yeah. But then you won the previous encounter, a draw in this one, 8-apiece. Still going well. I think plenty of confidence after leg 5.
So. Not bad. I mean, it's a good start.
Yeah, it's a good start. I think we've still yet to see the best of the Sherdils. I'm sure it's yet to come.
Day 13 has also ended with a tie, which means that our all teams are giving each other a competition. After today's day, this is what the leaderboard looks like. The Marksmen and Yakshas are top of the board at 47 points each. Close behind are the Sherdils with 43 points. Next, with 29 points, are the Yodhas, Akramaks with 24, and the Crusaders are at 18.
To watch the entire gameplay, you can log on to usports.in. And tomorrow we have a very, very interesting matchup. A team who are at the top of the table and a team who are at the bottom of the table. We have Marksmen versus the Crusaders. So see you guys tomorrow, same time, same place, only on Ucypher Naya Sport, Naya Superstars, a U Sports initiative. My name is Varun.
And I'm Aisha. Do Ucypher.
Thanks, Ucypher, for supporting us, and we're going to give you results.
Still now, we have 6 matches. We are going to make this comeback, and comeback is real, guys.